राइट, एम आई राइट और नॉट?
यस मैम.
ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट. बिस्मिल्लाह. ओके, फॉर दिस वर्ड एग्जाम्पल, वर्ड एग्जाम्पल 6.10, दिस इज द लास्ट एग्जाम्पल इन योर बुक. ओके, एंड फॉर दिस एग्जाम्पल यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द फुट ब्रिज, अनदर फुट ब्रिज. ओके, ऑन पेज 170 यू कैन सी दैट देर इज अ फुट ब्रिज विच इज अ समरी ऑफ ऑल ऑफ द फुट ब्रिजेस. ओके, सो देर आर एक्चुअली 3 फुट ब्रिजेस इन योर कोर्स. 2 ऑफ देम वी स्टडीड एंड द थर्ड वन इज ऑलरेडी रिटन इन द समराइज्ड फॉर्म. ओके, in this full version. So let me just explain it very quickly to you. Okay, for whatever thing is given to you, first you have to convert it into moles. Okay, whatever thing is given, for example, if the mass is given to you, if the volume is given, if the concentration and volume is given, convert it into moles. Okay, see figure 6.18. This is a summary of different ways in which a balanced equation acts as a footbridge. Okay, so the first one, this is the first footbridge mass of the reactant. So if mass of one substance is given to you, then convert it into the moles of that substance. Okay, from the mass, convert it into moles. This is the footbridge which we used in experiment 6.6 or example 6.6. Okay, so example which is in your book 6.6, in this example, we use this footbridge. From the mass which is given to you, given to us of the reactants, convert it into moles. From the moles, using the ratio of the equation, we turn it into moles of the product. Okay, by taking reactant ratio product from the equation. And when we turn it into products, when we find the moles of the product, then we can find the mass of the product which is required to us. Third step. Okay, so we have like three steps here. One. Okay, in first step, find the number of moles. Second step, find the number of moles of the other substance. Okay, and third step is find the mass of the substance which is asked. Okay, so this is the first bridge, first foot bridge, simple one. The second one is pink. Okay, volume of a gas, this one. So if the volume of a gas is given to you, convert it into moles. Okay, in short, you have to convert everything into moles. So whatever thing is given to you, convert it into moles first. Okay, so if something is given, for example, volume of substance one is given to you. Okay, any substance volume is given to you, convert it and they ask you about the volume of substance two. Okay, substance one volume is given and they're asking you to find the volume of substance two. So how will you find it? You can first convert the volume of substance one into moles of that substance. Convert it into moles. Then from moles of substance one, convert it into the moles of substance two by taking the ratio of the equation. Okay, by taking the ratio of the two moles, you will find from one mole, find the other moles. Okay, then from the moles of substance two, you can find the volume of substance two by using the formula. Okay, so these are the four, this is the footbridge and very easy footbridge. So volume of a gas converted into moles, then from moles of the reactant converted into moles of the product, from moles of the product converted into the volume of the product or the mass, whatever is asked. Okay, if the mass is asked, you can use the formula. For this one, for the mass, you can use the formula moles is equal to mass divided by molar mass. Okay, and if you have to find the volume, then moles is equal to volume divided by molar volume. This formula you will use. Okay, you have moles formula for all of the stuff in terms of mass also, in terms of volume also. Okay, and now this is the third footbridge. This footbridge, the second one footbridge, you used in example 6.8. Okay, now example 6.10. For example 6.10, you are using this formula. Okay, that concentration and volume is given to you. Okay, you have to convert it into moles. Okay, then from the moles, you have to convert it into moles of the product or the moles of substance two. Okay, then from moles of substance two, find out the concentration or whatever thing is asked. Okay, the formula which we use for the concentration is, if you remember the formula of moles in terms of concentration, what is it? Moles is equal to
concentration times volume.
Very good. Concentration times volume, or concentration into volume. This is the formula of moles in terms of concentration and volume. Okay, so this formula we will use. So we'll keep in mind this formula and the ratio of the two substances, and we'll solve the question, the example 6.10. Understood these footbridges?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, after completing this chapter, inshallah, we'll do the, in the next class, we'll do some questions also, which are related to these footbridges, the past paper questions.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, now see this question. The solution of hydrochloric acid is titrated against a standard sodium hydroxide solution. Okay, I hope the book is in front of you. Okay, so please everyone see it and write on it also, whatever you think is important. A solution of hydrochloric acid is titrated against sodium hydroxide solution. So HCl is titrated against sodium hydroxide. Okay, and we all know that salt and water is formed in this reaction. Okay, and whatever is the products, sodium hydroxide, so sodium chloride and water. It is found that 20 centimeter cube of acid neutralizes 25 centimeter cube of 0.10 moles per decimeter cube sodium hydroxide. Okay, so three things are given to you. One thing is volume of the acid. So for HCl, the volume is given to you, which is 20 centimeter cube. Okay, and neutralizes 25 centimeter cube of NaOH. So for NaOH also, the volume is given, which is 25 centimeter cube. Okay. And for NaOH, what is this thing? Moles per decimeter cube. What is
concentration?
This is concentration. Concentration is equal to 0.10 moles per decimeter cube. Okay. What is the concentration of hydrochloric acid? Okay, the concentration of hydrochloric acid is required. Okay. So it will become, in America, will become easy if you write the data like this, okay? And like I always write data, okay, that which thing is given to us, which thing is required, equation and everything. So it will be easy for me to understand the question then, okay, to understand and which formula you will use. Okay, see, now NaOH, for NaOH, the information is given to us. So NaOH, we consider NaOH as substance one. Okay, this is substance one, and for the substance for which we have to find out something, this is substance two. Okay, mark it as substance two. Okay, now make a footbridge that from volume and concentration of NaOH, means substance one, from volume and concentration, we will find the moles of NaOH. Okay. Then from the moles of NaOH, we will find out the moles of HCl, okay, which is required. And from moles of HCl, we can find the concentration of HCl finally. Okay, so we will follow these steps. Step number one, step number two, and step three. Okay, so make this footbridge. Okay, then see the example. First one is to find the number of moles of NaOH, okay, which they did in step number one. Okay, step number one is number of moles of NaOH is equal to concentration into volume. The same formula, concentration moles is equal to concentration into volume. Okay, but they have converted volume into volume is in centimeter, so they will convert it into decimeter by dividing by 1000. What is the answer?
0.025.
0.025 decimeter cube. Okay, now you can substitute this value. No need to divide this concentration. Okay, directly just write the formula. First convert the volume centimeter cube into decimeter cube and then substitute. Okay, and they have written the answer in scientific notation. But what will be the answer? Concentration is 0.1 mole per decimeter cube. So concentration is 0.1 multiplied by 0.025. What is the answer?
0.00025.
Wait, let me just confirm. Are you a boys calculating? Please do
yes,
it on calculator, okay?
Ma'am, it came 2.5 times 10 to power minus 3.
Do you know how to convert in scientific notation, how to convert scientific notation into decimals?
Yes, ma'am.
Through calculator? There's a button in a calculator which converts it, right?
Yes.
Okay, 0.0025. This is the number of moles of NaOH, the first step. Okay, the second step is from number of moles of NaOH of one substance, find the number of moles of the second substance by taking the ratio. Okay, so this in step number two, the equation is written HCl plus NaOH gives NaCl plus H2O. Okay, and these are the two things by which we are concerned, with which we are concerned, HCl and NaOH. Okay, so this whole line is written. You can write it simply that NaOH ratio HCl. Okay, NaOH, according to the equation, if NaOH is 1, HCl is also 1. So if NaOH is 0.025, what will be HCl?
0.0025.
Yeah, same, 0.0025 moles. Okay, so in this way, we got the moles of HCl. Okay, now if we have the moles of HCl, can we find its concentration?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, yeah. Ma'am.
Volume is given to us. Okay, so we'll use the same formula. Moles is equal to concentration into volume. Okay, first let's convert volume into volume is in centimeter, convert it into decimeter. Yeah, what is it?
No, it's not 0. It's not 25.
Then what is it?
It's 20.
Okay, 25 is sodium hydroxide. Okay, thank you. It's 20. Okay, yes, convert it. 0.02 decimeter cube. Good. Okay, so the number of moles, substitute the values, 0.0025 moles. Okay, concentration is required and the volume is 0.02. Okay, take it on the other side, divide and tell me the answer.
0.125
divided by 0.02.
I'm 0.125 moles per decimeter.
Yeah, 0.125 moles per decimeter cube, which is written here also in the example. Okay, is this example clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. Alhamdulillah. Okay, now after this, there is a small topic of concentration and solubility data. Okay, there is no numerical or no question related to this topic. This is just for the explanation and for information. Okay, and in this topic, they are saying the solubility and saturated solution. Solubility is actually, solubility is the ability of a solute to dissolve in a solvent. Okay, to dissolve in a solvent. Very simple, at a particular temperature. At a particular temperature. So tell me, is the solubility same for all the temperatures?
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Yeah, at different temperatures, solubility is different, right? That for example, it's sodium chloride salt. When we dissolve salt in water, at 25 degrees Celsius, its solubility or the amount of sodium chloride which dissolves in it is, for example, it's 5 grams. Okay, 5 grams are dissolved in water at 25 degrees Celsius. And if we try to dissolve more, then more salt will not dissolve. It will settle down at the bottom. Okay, it can means this is the maximum amount which can be maximum amount of NaCl which can be dissolved at 25 degrees Celsius in water. Okay, this is a maximum amount. So at this temperature, this solution in which the maximum solute is present, no more solute can be added. What is the name given to this solution?
saturated solution.
Yeah, that is, this solution is then known as saturated solution. Okay, it's written here. There's such a solution. The maximum mass of solid that will dissolve in 100 grams of water is found at each temperature. Such a solution is said to be saturated at that temperature. Okay, it is a saturated solution. Okay, and when we heat it, what will happen?
More solid will dissolve.
Yeah, because temperature is directly proportional to solubility. Okay, so when the temperature increases, solubility also increases. When we increase the temperature from 25 to 30 degrees Celsius, for example, then more the further amount of the salt, it will also start dissolving. Okay, and still after this, like it will, the more salt will dissolve, so solubility increases. But after this also, even after heating, a time comes when no more solute dissolves. Okay, it will start settling down at the bottom. Okay, so that means that it has received the maximum limit at this temperature. Okay, and this is a saturated solution at 30 degrees Celsius. So saturated solutions are also different at different temperatures. Okay, because of the solubility. Now, because of these, if we take different solutions, different saturated solutions at different temperatures, if we consider their solubility, then how much salt is dissolved at these temperatures, then we can plot a graph, okay, between the two. Solubility on x-axis. If we plot a graph, solubility on one side and temperature solubility on y-axis and temperature on x-axis. Okay, then if we make a graph between solubility and temperature, we get a curve like this, like increasing curve. Okay, because as we increase the temperature, solubility also goes up. Solubility is also increasing. So that is why the graph graph goes up. Okay, but we get a curve. This curve is known as solubility curve. Okay, it's written in the book. So this is solubility curve. The values at each temperature can then be plotted to give a solubility curve. Such curves can be useful in comparing the solubilities of different salts and for predicting the yields produced on crystallization. So this solubility can be this solubility curve, these graphs can be used to compare the solubilities of different salts. Okay, different salts at same temperature or different salts at different temperatures also. And for predicting the yields. Okay, predicting the yields. Yield is, I told you that yield is produce. Okay, that how much amount is produced. This is the yield. So we can predict the yields also from this graph. How we can tell the yields? Because the two things, substance A and substance B, if they are reacting with each other and we increase the temperature, so their reaction or their reactivity increases or decreases in that case?
Increases.
Yeah, their reactivity increases, means they are more soluble in each other and their reaction will be fast. Okay, they will react more or at a quicker rate. So when the temperature is increased, then their solubility or reactivity will also increase. And if their reactivity increases, then they form more product in that case. Okay, they will produce more, the yield will be more. Okay, so we can predict the yield also by the solubility curve, that if the temperature is more, the solubility is more, so the product will also be more. Okay, and vice versa, the other way. If it is less, solubility is less, reactivity will be less, and less product will be produced. Okay, so we can use this graph for these things. The plotting of the graph will not come, okay, obviously, because there's only one small topic. Okay, but the questions related that can come means the questions will be the same, like you, in which you have to calculate the moles, concentration of solution and everything, but they can give you statement like this, in which the saturated and solubility curve can words are used. Okay, like for the titration, we did the example. For the titration also, a small topic of titration is given in your book. Okay, and for the titration, only these type of questions can come, like the statement can be given related to titration. Okay, similarly, a statement can be given related to solubility, saturated solution or solubility curve. Okay, but otherwise the calculation will be the same, which you did in book. Okay, now there are last questions on page 171. Let's discuss these questions and finish. Okay, but before these questions, I will post the answer key of end of chapter questions in your in files chemistry section.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, these are the answers. I have the PDF file of the answers of end of chapter questions. Okay, for the other classes also, I posted these end of chapter questions and I asked them to do these questions by yourself, by themselves. Okay, so the answers are really small. They are not hard. Okay, the first question is long, but it's just the story. It means that you need to understand what are they asking in question one. Okay, so read it and understand, try to understand what are they saying. Okay, and in rest of the questions from 2 to 7, you can see that the answers are really small. Okay, so you have to do a little bit of calculation and take out the answers. Okay, check your answers and then try to do them. Okay, and today is Tuesday. I cannot ask you to do them before Thursday because on Thursday your assessments are starting. So I cannot give any homework during assessments. Okay, but try to do these questions like within these 2 days. Okay, because any question from these questions can come. End of chapter questions. Okay, so please try when you prepare for the exam, like for as a practice. When you do practice, when you practice the past papers, then practice these questions first. Okay, and in your neat copy. And if you have still any confusion or any question, then you do let me know. Okay, you can ask me questions. If it's anything hard. Okay. Then, do these questions, okay? Don't leave them. The end of chapter questions, the chapter questions, all of them are really important. Okay, these questions also, which I'm discussing with you, the questions and all the examples which are booked, they are also really important. Okay, they can come. Because we know that the most chapter is a little bit hard for you. So maybe the teachers can give the questions from within the chapter. Because within the chapter, all the examples we solve during explanation, we solve with the class, so they can come. Okay. Now question 6.8. Someone wrote in the chat box, right? No. Okay.
Deleted.
It's deleted. Okay, we have 10 minutes, so we can do these questions. 6.8. Okay, they're really easy. 6.8, calculate the number of moles of gas there are in the following. Okay, so calculate the number of moles of gas. Okay, it's about the gas. So which formula we will use to find the number of moles?
Mass over relative formula.
Volume over molar volume.
Oh, yeah. Okay, not the mass one. Mass one is for solids and liquids. Okay. For the gases, I told you that we cannot measure the mass of a gas because it's negligible. We will measure its volume. Okay. So whenever there is a gas, to find its number of moles, we will use the volume formula. And as you can see in A, B, and C also, the volume is given to you. In A, for example, in A, I'm solving only one. 480 centimeter cube. Okay, this volume is given. And for the formula, moles is equal to volume divided by molar volume. Okay, volume is given to you, which is 480. Molar volume is 24 decimeter cube. Okay, but the units are different. So what will you do first?
Divide by 1000.
Which value?
480.
To 480, we will divide this by 1000 to convert it into decimeter. So what is the answer?
0.48.
Okay, 0.48 decimeter cube. Okay, now substitute this value and take out the answer. Okay, number of moles. It's very simple. You just have to substitute the values in the formula. In A and in C also, you need to convert because it is also given in centimeter cubes, but B is already given in decimeter cubes, so no need to convert. Directly substitute the value 48 in the numerator and 24 in the denominator. Divide and take out the answer.
Ma'am, okay, 0.02.
This one for the first one?
0.48 divided by 24, so the answer is 0.02.
0.02 moles. Good. Okay. And experiment question 6.9. Question 6.9 is calculate the volume in centimeter cube of the following. Okay, now in this one, 6.9, you have to calculate the volume, and the volume is also should also be in centimeter cube, not decimeter cube. Okay, and the number of moles are given, number of moles of these gases, nitrogen, ammonia, and chlorine. Okay, so we will use the same formula. Moles is equal to volume divided by molar volume. Okay, moles value is given to you. Okay, like in number one, if I solve part A, then moles 1.5, volume you need to find. Okay, and the molar volume, boys, molar volume is in 24. Molar volume is, molar volume is 24 decimeter cube, but you have to give the answer in centimeter cube. So what will you do?
Ma'am, we will divide it by 100.
Divided or multiply? We have to
divide by 1000.
Multiply by 1000.
Multiply by 1000, because we have to convert decimeter into centimeter now.
24,000.
Yeah. Okay, it will be 24,000. Okay, now you can take it on the other side and tell me the answer.
36,000.
It will be centimeter or decimeter?
Centimeter cube.
Yeah, centimeter cube. Okay, so that's how you will do these type of questions, okay, in which the volume is asked in centimeter. So please see it carefully, okay, that the question is asked in which units, and which units are given to you. So if it is given in decimeter, no need to convert. Yeah, but if it is in centimeter, then convert. Or if the question is asked that give the answer in centimeter cube, then convert the decimeter into centimeter. Okay, and then substitute the values. Okay, then 6.10. Okay, in 6.10. Calculate the concentration in moles per decimeter cube of the following solutions. Concentration in moles per decimeter cube. These are the units, okay?
Means in 6.9, you wrote 69.
It went up. Okay. Okay, see, in A, B, and C. In both of these questions, in all of these questions, in first three questions, number of moles are given to you. Okay, 1.0, 0.2, and 0.1 moles. Number of moles are given to you, and the volume is also given. Okay, volume is given in centimeter cube for all of these three. What is the formula of concentration?
Concentration is equal to moles over volume.
Over volume.
Yeah, moles divided by volume. Okay, moles are given to you in all of the three questions. Volume is also given to you, but volume is given in centimeter cube. So first you will convert it into decimeter by dividing by 1000. Okay, whatever it will come, it will be in decimeter cube. So you can substitute the value and take out the answer in moles per decimeter cube. Okay, keep the unit same. But in part D, it's 0.8 grams. Okay, the mass, the amount of a substance, because for the concentration, when we are discussing concentration, we said that concentration is the amount of solute. Okay, amount of solute, and it can be expressed in grams also, divided by volume. Okay, here the volume is given to you in decimeter cube, so no need to convert the volume. Okay, but the amount of solute is given to you in grams. Okay, and the concentration you have to find in moles per decimeter cube. So convert these grams into moles. Do you know how to convert it?
Yes, ma'am.
Grams into moles?
Mass divided by molar mass.
Mm-hmm. What about the other students? They're so quiet. Please participate. Tell me, what is the simplest formula which we used, like which we studied in the starting? Come on, who will tell me? Instead, like apart from Abdul Rafi. Should I ask from anyone, like by taking the names?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so Ahmed. Ahmed Nawaz. Yes, are you here, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Do you know which formula we will use?
Mole is equal to mass over molar mass.
Very good. Awesome. Moles is equal to mass divided by molar mass. Okay. And we will find the number of moles. Mass is, who will substitute the values? Mubashir Hussain.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, what is the mass, beta? C part D.
Oh, ma'am, yes, the mass.
In grams, what's the value?
Ma'am, should I do it first and like that?
Yeah, but you can just tell me right now, like, see, part D is 0.8 grams of solid sodium hydroxide is dissolved. So what is the mass here? What is the value of mass? It's very simple. It's here in front of you. It's 0. Something, Mubashir?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, no, 0. Come on.
0.8.
Abdul Rafi, you're helping him. Okay, Zain Ahmed, good.
Yes,
0.8, beta. 0.8. Okay, the mass is 0.8. It's written 0.8 grams. Okay, so what will be the molar mass?
Molar mass
will be the RFM of sodium hydroxide. Okay, the RFM of sodium hydroxide. So sodium is 23 plus oxygen is 16 plus hydrogen is 1. Okay, so what is the total?
Ma'am, it will be 17 plus 23. So the answer will be 40.
Yes, so 40 grams, 40 is the molar mass. Okay, so 0.8 mass divided by molar mass, 40. Okay, when you divide, then it will give you the number of moles.
0.02 moles.
0.02 moles.
Okay, so these are the number of moles. Okay, so number of moles you can find like this. Okay, if anything is given to you in grams, then convert it into moles from this formula. Okay, so moles are 0.02. Okay, and the volume is given to you 1 decimeter cube. So you can directly substitute it in the formula of concentration now.
Period.
Okay, take out the answer. Yeah, period is over. Okay, so the chapter is also complete. Inshallah, next time we'll start discussing the past papers. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, beta, you can go now. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Allah Hafiz.
Allah Hafiz,
ma'am.
Allah Hafiz,
ma'am. Allah Hafiz. Bye bye.